So I want to talk about one of the key figures, or one of the 30 featured figures in Even More Fantastic Failures, the second volume, and that is Congresswoman Ayanna Pressley. So back in 2018, she ran for to represent in Congress, in the United States Congress, the 7th district in Massachusetts. And her story is just awesome and remarkable and inspiring in so many ways. Ayanna Pressley ran against someone who had held that seat for 10 terms, so 20 years, a guy named Michael Capuano. Michael Capuano had held the seat for 20 years. He's what we call an incumbent. So he had been there a long time, and pretty much everybody thought there was no chance that Ayanna Pressley was going to win against Michael Capuano for this seat. Even a lot of the big head leaders in the Democratic Party sort of announced their support for Michael Capuano and thought, hey, he's going to win, even though this woman, Ayanna Pressley, is trying to defeat him. He's definitely going to win, and we support him. And there, even key leaders from all around the country, Democratic leaders, said they support him. Ayanna Pressley was unfazed. She said, "I'm going to run this race. I'm going to speak about principles like justice and equality and progressive politics." And she refused to be pushed back, even by leaders in the party who said, "Just don't run this race, or that you've got no shot." And that's a powerful idea about failure, that we have to be willing to face failure to achieve something really, really beautiful and really meaningful in society or in ourselves. So Ayanna Pressley took a huge risk, right? She knew that there wasn't necessarily a great shot based on historical trends that incumbents, people who already have the seat in politics, who are already in office, tend to keep winning, right? And Michael Capuano had proved that. 10 terms he served, 20 years he'd been there. And here comes Ayanna Pressley saying, "Not another term. I'm going to get into office, and I'm going to try to introduce policies and fight for progressive change that includes all people, that's more inclusive, that's more equitable." And she believed her 7th district needed someone representing that district that had those principles and fought for those values in a more authentic and deeply passionate way. And so she won. And even though this book is a book about failure, along the way, she had been pushed back and rejected again by people who were sort of supporting him over her. And she continued moving forward. She continued to strive to win, even though others told her it wouldn't happen. There's a great quote by Soren Kierkegaard, and he says, "To dare is to lose one's footing momentarily. Not to dare is to lose one's life." It's a really, really poignant quote. And I think Ayanna Pressley's race in 2018 for the 7th seat in Massachusetts lives, or sort of brings that quote to reality in a very powerful way. To dare is to lose one's footing momentarily. Not to dare is to lose one's life. In other words, to take a risk, to try something that other people say, that's probably very unlikely or impossible. To take those risks, to take that dare, that challenge, might mean that for a while we're off balance. It feels hard. Or it might mean, as in Ayanna Pressley's case, that you have a lot of big wigs and people who are very powerful within a political party or a school or a classroom or a sport who are telling you, "Hey, we want this other person instead of you, and we support them instead of you." And so it might cause you to lose your footing, but not to dare is to lose your purpose, is to lose your life, to stop taking risks, to try to do what you believe you need to do. That's the way you lose your balance permanently, not just for a bit. And so Ayanna Pressley's story is quite powerful and inspiring to me, and it's one of the stories in Even More Fantastic Failures. Thanks, and I hope you have a wonderful rest of your day.